A very pleasant afternoon to all attendees, esteemed faculty members, and research scholars who have joined us today. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to this live international webinar on nanomaterials and its tools, organized by Department of Physics, Hidaya College for Women, Kumbakonam. A very enthusiastic and knowledgeable resource person who have with us today, Dr. S. Sundaramurthy, Assistant Professor, Agni College of Technology. He is going to deliver a very interesting and thought-provoking presentation today. Before we move on to the welcome address, I would like to remind all the attendees who have joined us today, stay with us till the end of the session. Now, I would call upon Mrs. K. Kanimudi, convener of this program, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
International webinar on nanomaterials and its tools, organized by the Teaching and Research Department of Physics, Hidaya College for Women, Kumbakonam. Session 2, move towards material characterization through quantum computing. I warmly welcome our resource person, Dr. S. Sundaramurthy, Assistant Professor of Physics, Agni College of Technology.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I am thankful to the management, principal, and the physics department of IDM College of Women to organize this international webinar to share my research contribution to you all present here. Now, let's see one of the very interesting and the strong base of the research area about the material characterization through quantum computation methods. Is it audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
You have confidence.
First of all, the characterization. The characterization describes those feature of composition and the structure of the material that are significant for a particular preparation, study of properties or uses, and suffice for reproduction of the materials. Mechanical, electrical, and the magnetic properties of a material are strongly dependent on its structural characteristics. So the electronic behavior or the electronic structures of number of electrons or varies, definitely it is affect the properties of the materials. So material characterization is very important part of any structure property correlation exercise. It is a fundamental process in the field of the material science, without which no scientific understanding of engineering materials could be ascertained. In general, materials characterization include different types. Example, surface characterization. So using the, this is called as the morphology, using the scanning electron microscope, atomic force microscope. So using this instrument, we find out the surface characterization. Next one is the structural characterization. This is used for the X or D, single crystal X-ray diffraction or neutron diffraction. Using this method, so the atomic structures are identified and the structure is analyzed. Next one is the physicochemical characterization. It is called as the FTIR, Fourier transformer, infrared, and FT-Raman, NMR. These all gives the physicochemical characterization of the materials. And another one is the mechanical characterization. It is gives the hardness test, elastic modulus value, and the thermal behavior of the material, and so on. So, but in the case, we will discuss that now, mainly the focus, the structural characterization and the physicochemical characterization. So material characterization has two main aspects. One is called accurately measuring the structure of the materials. So accurately measuring the structure of material means the perfect position of the electrons or perfect position of the atom inside the crystals. Another one is accurately measuring the physical and chemical properties of the materials. So physical and chemical properties are completely dependent on the electronic structure of the atom. So structural behavior gives the physical and chemical property. After the structural confirmation, we get the different type of the physical phenomena and chemical properties of the materials. X-ray diffraction. Single X-ray diffraction is a non-destructive analytic technique which provides a detailed information about the internal structure of crystalline substance, particularly which provides the unit cell dimension, bond length, bond angle, packing, supramolecular networks, and the details of the site ordering. So what is the exact position of the atom placed inside the crystal? It is the most powerful method to determine the three-dimensional structure of the molecules. Obtaining a crystal structure. These are four steps in obtaining a X-ray crystal structures. So first one is to grow on X-ray quality crystals. The first step is usually performed by the experimental chemist. The following steps are performed by the crystallographer. The second one is to collect the data. It is the collect the SIF file. Third one is to create an initial structure and finally solve the structures. We will take it now. First one is step one, the growing crystal. Growing an X-ray quality crystal more often than not is much easier said than done. The growing of crystal can be deemed an art as concentration, solubility, temperature, and luck, all factors into the result. There are several techniques used in crystal growing, including but not limited to vapor diffusion, evaporation, solvent laying, and seeding. So many different methods are possible. So we are using the selected method for the different materials. Second one is that collect the data or collect the SIF file. After obtaining a suitable crystal for an X-ray experiment, an X-ray diffrometer is used to collect the crystal data. This instrument is designed to aim X-ray beams through a crystal and record where the beam diffract and the intensity of the reflection. Third one is to create an initial structure. This step is related with the computer work carried by the crystallographer. When data collection is finished, the position of the reflection are converted into HKL file. So this HKL indices and the intensities of the reflection into amplitudes. These values make it possible to create an electron density map. This electron density map is not give the exact position or exact structure of the molecules, which then leads to an creation of an initial structure. This is the incomplete structure. So in this diagram, so this is the given collected data. So this collected data is convert into HKL file. So then HKL file is using the HKL file, using the electron density map, then electron density map, finally we get that now incomplete crystal structure. The last one is solve the structure. In order to create a more complete model of the crystal, the initial estimated phase need to be refined. By adding or deleting atom, altering the element choice, or accounting the thermal vibration, each process will hopefully produce a better model. This process is called refinement, and it is done to bring the model closer to the actual structural. So these four steps are basic structure, basic steps for obtaining the crystal structures. Next one is the density function theory. This is the first, last one is the XOD is the experimental part. Then we enter now the theoretical part. So density function theory is an extremely successful approach for the description of ground state properties of organic compounds, metals, semiconductors, and insulators. Density function theory stimulation solve the electronic structure of material starting from the Schrodinger equation, DFT, and its software was successfully developed by Professor John F. Hobel and Walter Cohn. The density function theory is completely explained by the Professor Hobel and the Professor Cohn. The Professor Hobel is responsible for popularizing the usage of quantum chemistry through his popular Gaussian program package. Professor Cohn is primarily responsible for formulating one electron wave function concept in the density function theory. Professor John Hobel and Walter Cohn got Nobel Prize for DFT approach to solve the molecular structure for the chemical field in the year of 1998. Here, Walter Cohn is the physics faculty and Professor Hobel is the chemistry faculty. So the density function theory is used to find out the electronic structure of molecules, geometry optimization, transition structures, protein calculation, electron and charge distribution, rate constant for the chemical reactions, thermodynamic calculations, heat of the reaction, and energy activation. Particularly useful for the determination of properties that are inaccessible experimentally, interpretation of experimental data. So the experimental data is not given the all visual idea about the molecular structures. So the theoretical concept gives the complete visualization of the molecular structure, molecular orbital, the energy transformation from one point to another point, and the vibration of the atoms inside the molecules. So in this case, we are using two different type of the softwares. One is called Gaussian 09W. This is used for the DFT calculation. So the whole DFT calculation is used in the Gaussian softwares. So many different softwares is also available, but the other softwares is not exactly coincide with the experimental data. So the DFT is the most approach, close approach to the experimental result. So most of the papers or most of the journals accept using the DFT calculation by the Gaussian softwares. So after calculation, the data and values using the DFT calculation, the Gaussian software, it is visualized using the GaussView softwares. It is also published by the Gaussian Inc. These are not the free softwares. So first of all, we'll take it now, the GaussView diagram. In this case of the Gauss-Schmidt diagram, you draw the our interest molecule structures using the Bilder fragment. So after draw the diagram, then we use the calculation table. So you select the keywords for the process. So after selecting the keyword, so it is saved in the Gaussian input file. The Gaussian input file feed into the Gaussian software. Then Gaussian software start to run the process. So depend the molecular structure, depend the keywords. So it will take the time 1 hour to nearly 1 week. So it is depend the molecular structure. Suppose you are using it, the very simple structure means it is process is complete very soon. Suppose it have the more than 4 or 5 rings, and we are using the very complicated, complicated means it is a very high precious keyword means it will take the more time compared to the initial one. After complete the Gaussian program, we get at now this type of the output file. The output file is called as dot out or dot log files. Suppose the input file is feed through Gauss view means we get at now log file. We get at now log file. Suppose you directly enter the molecular structure in the Gaussian software, we get at now dot out file. So both have used the same result. The just name only differ from the way of the enter into the site. So this is the general notes for the Gaussian output file. What is the name of the checkpoint file name? And this is showed now the keywords used for the calculation. Here optimized is equal to tight, and the frequency is calculated. Raman frequency is also included in the combination. So B3 LOP is the basis value. 63 plus 11 is the basic factor. Here plus plus is the difference function. B comma P is the potential factor of the molecular structure, and the POP equal to ESP is represented here. Electrostatic potential of the molecular structures. So this is the initial parameters. So first of all, we draw the diagram in the Gauss view. We get at the molecular structure. This molecular structure is not exactly like as the experimental result. So this broad structure have some parameter value. Example, we show at now the packed bond length only. So the bond length R of 1,10 means the distance between the R1 molecules and the R10 molecules. This value equal to 1.3826. This is the approximate value. So this is the initial value before the optimization, before the calculation of the DFT value. So run the program, Gaussian program. After run the Gaussian program, we get at now the process is completed. The process is completed means it shows the maximum force value is converged. It is nearly one value. The threshold value equal to 15. The RMS force value equal to converged. Maximum displacement, RMS displacement, all values are completely converged. So the Gaussian process is completely over, and the optimization is completed. Optimization is completed means we get at now the stationary point is found. So this is the exact position at the ground state of the molecules. This is the optimized parameters. The initial one is the we get the data or the bond length from the drawing using the Gauss view material. This one is the optimized parameter. After complete the optimization, we get at now the exact position of the molecules at the ground state. So this value is definitely deviate from the initial one. So we get at now the optimized structures. So here I show at now only the bond length of the molecules 1,10, 1,11, 1,15. Here 1,10 is represents the atom names. Okay. Later I will show the name of the atom in the 1,10 means. Okay. So then the same way we find out how we get the bond angle, the angle between the any three atom, or the torsional angle, the angle between the 4 different atom planes. So bond length, bond angle, and the torsional angles are get from the optimized tables. So this is the XRD and DFT structure of the particular molecules. The XRD and DFT structure of the molecules, first case we catered now, this is the XRD structure. In the case of the XRD structure, we get data from the single crystal X-ray diffraction SIF file. Using the SIF file, it is uploaded in the HOTEP molecular software. So HOTEP diagram is getted now. So this is get the visual structure from the HOTEP molecular softwares. Then right-hand side is called as the DFT structure. It is get from the Gaussian software. After the optimization, the molecular structure is exactly fixed the exact position at the ground state. So these DFT and the XRD structures are nearly coincide without any deviation. So this is the very, very important advantage of the DFT software Gaussian. So the Gaussian softwares only gives this exact coincidence with the experimental result. Okay. How to check these two values are exactly coincide, experimental result and the DFT result? So use that now, the QMODE software version 3 is used for this case. The XRD data, SIF data and DFT values, both data files are converted into PDB and the PDB file is uploaded in the QMODE software, then it is superimposed or overlapping to these molecules. We get at now the superposition of XRD and DFT structures. The RMSE values of 0.036, root mean square equation value is 0.036, means this value is very, very low, means the two atoms or two structures are exactly coincide. Now, low value of RMSE value indicates the DFT calculation well reproduces the geometry of original molecules. So, the experimental result is the confirmation methods. So, after the confirmation, this value is compared to the experimental result, sorry, theoretical result, DFT result. The DFT result is exactly coincide with the experimental one. So the calculated DFT value is same like as the experimental one. So using this output file, we find out at now the charge of the particles. So this is called at now the Millikan charges. So each atom is placed inside the molecule, definitely it have some contribution of the other atoms. So finally we get at now the charge of the each atom has a different value. Suppose we will take at now the carbon atom of this position of 0.9284. So next case we take at now the another one carbon atom. This is the another one carbon atom. This is the methyl carbon atom. The methyl carbon atom have the value equal to minus 0.2715. So both are the carbon molecule, carbon atom, but it has a different value inside the molecules. It is completely different on the environment of the molecules. So using the Gaussian output file, we find out the charge of the each molecules, N1, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, carbon, and all molecules charge values are easily identified. These values are directly reported in the journal papers. Next one is the frontier molecular orbitals. It is generally called as now FMO. The frontier molecular orbital means the molecular orbital is completely covered by the electrons. So first of all, electrons occupy in the lower energy levels. So energy state is increased from the higher point to lower point. So this is the graph is showed now. The energy value is the increase. So the lowest value of the alpha occupied electron energy value equal to 101 into 57050, then 19, then 19 point some value, and the 1410. The value is decrease in the manner. So this is the very, very highest occupied energy levels. Highest occupied energy levels. The blue values are called as now occupied energy states. Here, another one is the red color values are called as now unoccupied energy levels or virtual energy states. So totally the molecule have 369 orbitals or energy levels are present. The 316 energy level, 54 energy levels are completely occupied. So the remaining 315 are called as unoccupied energy level or empty levels. So the highest occupied energy level is called at now HOMO, or this is called at now HOMO. Highest occupied energy level is called at now HOMO. And this value in this diagram is represented at now -0.23273. Another way, the empty energy states are present. So the lowest empty energy state are unoccupied. So this is called unoccupied orbital. This is called at now HOMO. In this case, the -0.07462 is called at now the LUMO value of the particular molecules. Next, we take at now the frontier molecular orbital or HOMO-LUMO diagram. So the diagram is shows at now the energy levels. Already we know about the each energy level have two energy state. One is the spin up and another one is the spin down. So each energy orbitals have two different energy states based on the Pauli exclusion principle. Up to the 54th energy levels are completely filled. Above the 55 and 55 above are completely empty. So the 54th orbital is called at now the HOMO orbital or highest occupied molecular orbital. This value equal to -0.23272. So the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital value is represented here, 55th orbital. This value is represented here, -0.07459. The values are in the Gaussian software gives only the Hertie value. The Hertie value convert into electron volt. So we get the value, the -0.07459 Hertie is equal to -2.0297 electron volt. This is the LUMO energy value. And another one is the HOMO energy value, -0.23272 is the HOMO value. And this value is represent the Hertie unit. Its electronic volt value equal to -6.3327 electron volt. The difference between HOMO and the LUMO energy value is right at now 4.2994 electron volt. So in this diagram, it shows that now the green colors is shows that now the nucleic attack or this is the positive charge and the gray is right at now the negative charge combination. So in the particular atom, the HOMO atom, the benzene or naphthalene ring is partially filled. Okay. So the chlorine atom attached to carbon is completely free. Any electron cloud is not occupied in the chlorine attached carbon atom, but in the case of the LUMO, the electron cloud is completely changed. Okay, it is not linked within the each atom. So each atom have the separate electronic clouds are present. So the electronic cloud change from the HOMO to LUMO represents the biological activity of the molecules. The He HOMO and the He LUMO energy difference is lesser value means the material is actively in the biological component. So this low value band gap, the low value HOMO-LUMO value is represents the biological activity of the molecules. Next one is the density of the diagram. So density of the state is represents the electron density in the particular energy interval. Suppose we will take it now. Along the x-axis, we take at now the density of spectrum value, and along the x-axis the energy value, and along the y-axis the energy spectrum value. So the green color shows the occupied orbitals, and the red color shows the unoccupied molecular orbitals. So the fluctuation, the values of the density of state is shows in the upper line, blue lines. So before the HOMO, the energy levels are completely filled and its density value is very, very higher, moderately filled. in the HOMO, after the HOMO, up to the LUMO level, the energy level is completely zero. So the energy gap is called that, you know, the band gap energy value. So the LUMO molecular is also have the different type of the energy states. The density of energy state is the most important for the molecule, because it is the main, or the, it is the key factor for the performance of the instrument using the materials. Next one is the molecular electrostatic. Molecular electrostatic potential, or MEP. The molecular electrostatic potential is connected with the electron density and is most important to identify the sites of nucleophilic and electrophilic attack. Interaction between hydrogen bonding, molecular size with shape and the charge distribution. The charge distribution of molecule in space represents different color based on variable polarity and visualized by molecular electrostatic potential map. In this diagram, so the axion have the more electronegativity. So this is line is called at now electrophilic attack. The blue color line is represented at now nucleophilic attack. So the whole structure, the charge distribution is not equally distributed. So this diagram is completely explained the charge distribution of the molecules. The color schemes for the molecular electrostatic potential surface is deepest red represents the electron rich or negative charge. Deepest blue represents the electron deficient or positive charge. Also, light blue, yellow, green represents slightly electron deficient, slightly electron rich, and a neutral region respectively. So this visualized structure is completely give the electronic configuration of the molecule and the charge distribution in the given molecules. Next one is the thermodynamical parameters. So the thermodynamical parameters is the very, very important for the material, because the specific capacity of the molecule, entropy, enthalpy is calculated without any further calculation. So these all values are taken from the Gaussian output files. So first of all, we'll take into the thermochemistry. Temperature is the room temperature. It is fixed at the initial condition. The pressure value equal to 1 atmosphere pressure. This is the normal pressure value. The molecular mass is calculated in the DFT method. We get the value equal to 209 into 209.02436 atomic unit, molecular unit. The experimental result gives the same molecular compound, the molecular mass value equal to 209.62. This value is very, very small difference from the experimental result. So definitely the experimental result is slightly deviate from the theoretical value, because it is completely depend the electron correlation and the basis of the programs, basis keyword of the program, basis set of the programs. So the rotational constant values is represented here 0.91126 and 0.48935, 0.31903. The zero point vibrational energy is equal to 427675.9 joule per mole, or 102.21699 kilocalorie per mole. So these all values are taken from the Gaussian output, and these values are directly used in the journal papers. So next one is the enthalpy value, enthalpy energy value. It is unit the kilocalorie per mole. And specific capacity of the molecules, it is find out the value. Then S is the entropy value. Entropy is also find out the total entropy value, and the translational, rotational, and vibrational entropy value is also find out using the DFT calculations. So these are the thermodynamical parameter value. This is the temperature value, total energy, zero point energy, potential constant value, and specific heat capacity. The all values are taken directly from the Gaussian output file. So in this case, we run the temperature value equal to 2098 Kelvin. Suppose we need the different temperature value, means we change the temperature value. Suppose we will take at 100, 200, 300, each 100 steps, we take the thermodynamic parameter value, we find out the translational, rotational, vibrational value, entropy, enthalpy, and specific heat value. All values are calculated using the DFT calculation. Suppose we will take at now, in this case, the molecule is run by the 100, 200, 300, up to the 1000 degree Celsius, we get the different capacity, specific capacity, entropy and enthalpy values. This entropy, enthalpy, all values are directly changed to the temperature value. The temperature dependent standard thermodynamic parameters like as heat capacity at constant pressure, entropy and enthalpy carried out by using the DFT calculation method for the temperature range from 100 Kelvin to 1000 Kelvin. The results shows that the thermodynamic parameters are linearly depend on the temperature value. The correlation between thermodynamic properties and the temperature T are shown in figure. In the diagram, so suppose in this diagram, along the x-axis, we take only the temperature value. Along the y-axis, we take at now the thermodynamic function. So we take at now the blue color line is represent the specific heat capacity at constant pressure value. And the next one is the entropy value. And the last one is the enthalpy value. So temperature will be increased. The thermodynamic parameter is also increased. This is the another one proof of the thermodynamic property and the correctness of the DFT softwares. Next one is the vibrational analysis. The number of normal mode of vibration is 3n minus 3 for linear molecules. In this case, n is represented here the number of molecules. Suppose we take at now only one atom is present, means we get at now 3 into 1 minus 3. So the number of normal mode vibration equal to 0. Suppose we take at now the n number of molecules. Okay. Suppose we take it now the n number of molecules. So it is multiplied with the 3n minus 3 for the linear molecule. Suppose the molecule is a non-linear molecule, means the value is equal to 3n minus 6 because the bending, it is the axis, the atoms are in the linear manner, the rotation axis is not have any constraint. But the non-linear means the rotation is also have some constraint value. So along the x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis, the three axes have some constraint value. So we get at now 3n minus 6. The calculated vibration wave numbers are usually higher than the observed wave number due to the combination of electron correlation effects and DFT basis set deficiency. In the DFT calculation, any one keyword is not a perfect keyword for the structures. So each structure have the different combination of the keywords. So any golden key is not possible in the DFT structure basis set. So each basis set have some different advantages. So depend the parameter, depend the structure, depend the properties, we change the different type of the keywords. So based on the keywords or basis set, the deviation is also different for the each case. We are using scaling factor for DFT value. It is depend the basis set is used for the DFT calculation. Suppose if we are using the different type of the keywords, each keywords of the different scaling factors. The vibrational assessment of wave number compute on the basis of potential energy distribution. This is represented at now, potential energy distribution or PED. By VEDA 4 program. So the PED value is calculated using the VEDA 4 program. After complete the optimization, frequency values are get from the Gaussian software. This out file is feed into the VEDA 4 diagram, VEDA 4 software. We get at now the assignment of the molecules. In theoretical experiment, theoretical calculation gives the each molecule vibration of the atom. So each atom have the different molecular vibration. So experimental result gives only the wave number only. So the infrared spectroscopy or Raman spectroscopy, it gives only the particular frequency value So this frequency value is represents the some functional group in the present in the molecule. But the DFT method gives the each atom of the molecule exhibit the vibration. So the vibration is visualized easily using the theoretical concept. So first of all, we take it now in this table. This is the experimental result, the wave number, infrared method, and another one is the Raman method, FT Raman method. This is the theoretical calculation, DFT method. After the scrolling, we get the value. This is the infrared intensity value. This is the Raman activity. So the assignment with the potential energy difference percentage. Suppose we take it now the first one. The DFT variable wave number equal to 3441. It is represents the NH vibration. In general, NH vibrations are present between the 3100 to 3450 wave numbers. So we get it now. The theoretical wave number around the range equal to 3441. It is the pure vibration. Pure vibration represents the potential energy distribution is the under value. So the nitrogen and hydrogen have the stretching vibrations are present. Stretching vibrations are present. So the video is not properly working here. So wait a few seconds. I will show the another one video. So this is the NH vibration. In the case of the NH vibration, it is only present in the molecules. At the wavelength number 3441, this type of vibration only present in the molecules. So NH vibration is completely pure vibration. Any vibration is not present in the molecules. So next one is the 2948. This is the theoretical DFT wave number and its corresponding Raman frequency value equal to 2942 and corresponding IR wave number equal to 2939. So these values are nearly coincide and it is exhibits the asymmetric wave function. It is also pure form of the wave assignment. So this is present in the methyl group. This is the asymmetric wave function. The next one is the 2888. Its Raman and IR value is 2839 and 2839. Both values are equal and these values are nearly coincide with the experimental result. And this is the symmetry vibrations or symmetry stretching modes. In this case, the symmetry stretching mode, it has CH vibration and also some other vibration is also present in the structures. So in this case, this is the NH vibration lost one. This is the CH asymmetric vibration. So one atom is enter into the molecule and another one atom is leave from the carbon. So this is the asymmetric vibration. So this type of the vibration is present inside the molecular structure. It is visualized only using the theoretical calculation method. So the particular wave number is given by the experimental result and theoretical result, both are coincide and theoretically we are visualize the vibration inside the molecules. The next one is the asymmetric vibration. Next one is the symmetric vibration. So the symmetry stretching means In this case, both molecules enter the carbon atom, and it is two and leave from the carbon atom the simultaneously. So this is called as stretching vibration, symmetry stretching vibrations. So this is the bending modes. So in this case, carbon-carbon hydrogen bending is present at here. The bending means three carbon atoms, three molecules are involved in the bending mode vibration. So this case, we take it now, carbon-carbon atom and one hydrogen atom is attached with this molecule. So this vibration is present in this case. So one more CCH vibrations are present in this case. So we get that now the whole molecule is vibrate. Okay. So in this case, we get the result of the vibrational assignment. So this is the asymmetric vibration. Next one is the symmetric vibration. It is also the pure material methyl group. So CH vibration only present in the particular frequency value. Next one is the 1564 is the IR value. 1562 is the Raman frequency value wave number. And the DFT value represented here 1573. And it have the CC vibration and also XCC bending vibration. Here beta is represented here bending mode. Nu is represented is the stretching mode, the carbon-carbon stretching, and also carbon-hydrogen-carbon bending is also present. So using the DFT calculation and using the VEDA program, we get that now each molecule as exhibits the proper vibration modes is explained. So this facility is only possible using the DFT or theoretical calculation. Experimental result, we cannot see in the vibration of the molecule. So we get only the wave number. Using the wave number, we get at now the frequency of the functional group. Okay, summary. The material characterization is discussed, particularly the X-ray diffraction, obtaining X-ray diffraction methods. The crystal structures are collecting from the X-ray diffraction values. Next, density function theory. This is the theoretical computational method. Using the density function theory, structures and superimposition of the XRD. So this structure gives the complete coincide with the theoretical result. Next one is the Millikan charges. Millikan charges, each atom have some different type of the charge. The same molecule also have the different charge inside the molecule, depend the environment. So we find out the Millikan charges and its value. Next one is the frontier molecular orbital. So it is called that now HOMO and LUMO. What is the energy of the HOMO energy value, LUMO energy value, and the electron transition from the HOMO to LUMO. So this all gives the biological activity of the molecules. Next one is the molecular electrostatic potential, the charge distribution of the molecular surface, and the density of the state electron is occupied inside the molecule, which is fine. Next one is the thermodynamic properties. The thermodynamic constants are calculated and draw the diagram. The diagram is exactly coincided with the standard value of the thermodynamic properties. Last one is the vibrational analysis. FTIR, FT-Raman are given, gives the frequency value for the functional group, but we cannot see the vibration of the molecule in the experimental result. So using the density function theory, we visualize the molecular vibration of the each atoms inside the molecules. It is stretching mode or asymmetric or asymmetric bending, or torsion, outward bending, scissoring. So all type of the vibrations are visualized using the density function theory. Up to this, I am going to conclude my part. If there is any query, you can ask now.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your excellent presentation, sir. Sir, we have received a wonderful comments as well as some questions from participants, sir.
Thank you.
The first question is the Gaussian surfaces software is free or not, sir?
It's not free software.
Free software.
Okay. We get the amount, then only we get the license.
Okay, sir.
It's not free software.
The second question the participant arises, how do you calculate HOMO LUMO graph, sir?
So after get the output file of the Gaussian output file, it is uploaded in the GaussView software. Okay, after you enter the GaussView software, we get at now the orbital molecular structure. So using the some basic parameter change, we get at now the direct structure. So it is way of the GaussView.
Okay, sir. One more question. What is the best method to measure dislocation density? What is the best method to measure dislocation density?
Dislocation existing. So DFT method is also gives the exact position of the atom. Suppose the atom is not exactly fit in the particular place, if the value is completely deviate from the experimental result, so easily find out the dislocation of the molecule using the DFT values. The values are completely deviate from the others.
So DFT method is suitable for this one.
What
one? DFT method is suitable.
Yeah, DFT method is also suitable. It is one of the way.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Mrs. Sasireka Bai to propose the vote of thanks. Sasi ma'am. Sasi ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir. I take this opportunity to express great thanks to our principal, Reverend Sister Dr. Yuji Namada, dynamic, flexible, and strict support for today and always. I express my deep gratitude to our respected administrators for their kindness, encouragement, and continuous support. And new special gratitude to all academics who are all participating in this webinar. I am happy to express vote of thanks to our staff members and all the people who have made a tremendous success. Finally, I leave you this inspiring quote of success. Success isn't just about what you accomplish in your life. It's about what you inspire others to do. Once again, thank you to one and all. Stay home, stay safe, and learn more. Thank you.
Thank you, Sasima. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your nice explanation, sir. Thank you, sir.